Generic greetings and welcome back to Airships Conquer the Skies once again. Apparently a mad scientist has been... Metropolis has been raided by a mad scientist. From there, in fact. So they're sending out their killer robots. There are robots. I wasn't too sure in the first episode whether they were sent out or not, but obviously they are. They've got a big minigun and also like a tentacle type thing that whips and hits for loads and loads and loads of damage. Anyway, in the previous episode, it was hit and miss. Managed to take one area and then lose an area, which hopefully I'm going to be able to take back very shortly. And that's good. That's what I wanted to see. The Al-Ikol Empire has managed to repel this other guy, which is good. So I'm just going to send a spy over to here. And then I'm going to move, invade straight away, not with anything else, just with this bomber, because they've got no standing forces there, as in they've got no airships, and any defences that they have will be pathetic, which is that little structure there. I click start the fight, I immediately win, it's GG. There we go. The day's ours, and that's victory. So what I'll do is I'll go to defences, I will scrap that, because, well, what else are we going to do with it? Build building, and we can't build a dark cube because we haven't got the money, so I guess I'll just leave that there. The problem is that I don't have... If they come again with that, I'm just not able to take them out. But let's just see. I've got decent income. I'm going to recall the spy from that area because we're just wasting money on that one. And I'm just checking out now. Do we want to build there? Well, we do need some defensive structure because otherwise they're just going to come and take it. They're going to ninja it. So, defences... Dark cube is 558, okay. Defences. Build building. Dark cube. Go on the back there, and that'll do us. So once that's built, like so, we're going to move over to here. And we're going to attack Stormness. So this will split these two, two bits here. He hasn't come to defend it, which is useful. Three defensive structures. I've got the bot fly, which I am probably going to... I was going to put it in reserve, but I think we'll be okay for now. You can put them in reserve, but it just means they won't be fighting there. These are all fine. Reserve's fine. And we'll start the fight. Although we've got dusk. Distracting light from the west means that shots fired from right to left are less accurate. So we've got the advantage on this one. So we'll start the fight. Immediately that one's on aim fire. The other one, we will move it a lot closer because it's grape shots. So we obviously want to do that. These two, we'll press move. And we want to move them... We don't even care about the height, because as soon as we get right above them, we shouldn't be able to be shot at. So let's just move them to there, which is hopefully in a straight line. So, victory. They've surrendered. Okay, that's good. So we'll go for a gentle takeover. So they realise that they can win that fight, and they've just decided to, you know, just knock on the head. So that's good. It means that I'm now going to get, hopefully, all those defences. So it's a gentle takeover. Otherwise, well, we might end up destroying them. In terms of defences, we've got this thing okay here. We're going to build building, another dark cube there. And, do I want to? No, maybe more reactionary forces is better. So build ship, we want to build the bot fly. I might actually move all of these to the legacy folder at some point as well. But we'll build a bot fly. There we go. And they're going to attack over there, rather. Can I get there quicker? I cannot. But I can invade there. Ah, they've turned back around. Fair enough. Okay. So invade here at Speltford. So we've got a straight fight. They've got... Looks like the conning tower of a submarine, but they've just forgot to build the rest of it. I'm guessing a bomber. Oh, no, it's a rocket. Ooh, hell's bells. It's also a large rocket. That is a very, very, very big rocket. Well, I have cannon. Start. Please win. There's the rocket. Oh, if this hits, it's going to be so bad. Oh, I don't like it. Oh, that's looking accurate as well. Oh, no, we're fine. So the AI knows where it needs to sit and... Oh, this is going to hurt. Oh, it knows where it needs to sit to get in the... Not to the vulnerable spots, but the dead zones of it. But you can't, that's because I've split these up, they can't get in the dead zones of all of it. Sadly, however, I'm having to deal with a rocket, and I'm having to deal with that big rocket by just firing four rifles at it, which is never good. So these guys, I'm just going to focus on repair. And as you can see, if we go to outside view, the rocket doesn't do crippling damage, as in it doesn't put a hole from one side to the other. It just splatters the area with a lot of damage. So this is a new type of vessel that we haven't seen before. It also looks... it looks very derpy. It's like the KV-2 of the skies. Which I have made in a previous episode. We're not going to be able to take that out unless we hit something vital. The rocket on there is known to be one of the most unstable substances known to humankind, as it tends to go up at the drop of a hat if it gets shot at. However, doesn't look like that's happening here. I'm just going to max speed this out, and yeah, I don't think we can win this. But I might as well keep the fight going. If we had more defenses here, we'd be able to take that out. No problem whatsoever. It's the lack of flak that's causing me the issue here. So, I've just got rockets myself, but I'm going to go over to aerial hussars. So, they've taken that out. I am now charging towards them, and if that's all they have, which I think it is, yes, I'm not really worried about this at all. So, I'm going to move quite far back. I'm actually going to reserve the bot fly. I don't really want that getting hit once and then taken out twice, because that's pretty much what will happen. These galleons are also also in the line of fire. They're quite vulnerable because the rocket's got a very good arc of fire. You can't see it, but I reckon as soon as it launches, it's just gonna launch towards me. Let's move these over to there. This guy, we know we're targeting that, and it looks like he's coming towards me, so I'm just gonna back up. There's my rifle. Ooh, that hurt them. That hurt them a lot. So you can see, the bomb bay has absolutely hammered it. But we can't issue commands very quickly, because these are bombers. And, oh, there's the suspendium chamber gone. There we go. Right, okay, quickly, move to the other side. Bombers, move to there. So you see the rocket, it's got a fairly good arc of fire. But I'm now out of it. Excellent. So what I'm going to do is just sit right behind it. It also has technically that bit of defensive structure over there, but yeah, not really. And it's going down. There's the bombers. Yeah. An airship with no propulsion, no lift, and two bombers. It's not going to go well, is it? A brutal takeover. There's nothing to lose. There we go. I'm going to invade over there straight away. I don't know what they've got there, but if we take this out, it means that we've taken this entire left flank. So, three grenadiers and two mid-level defensive structures. Okay, need to take out the grenadiers first. The bot fly, sadly, not very good service ceiling at all. That could be a problem. Let's start that. Going to move. Actually, we're not going to move at all. We're going to stay because these guys are going to have to go underneath the bombers in order to come towards me. So, good luck to them. So we've got like a defensive line going there, and whoa, hell's bells, that's not good. We've just been hit by lightning, and it's taken out one of the suspendium chambers. Ooh, we fired up the emergency one though. We're fine. Right, so we'll move this back over there. This one will move back to there. You can see that the bomber is now crippled. It's gone. It's lost the other suspendium chamber. That's all kinds of bad. And what's happening here is something weird. That's not what I wanted to see. My suspendium chamber's gone as well. Right, this is not looking too good, actually. Let's move my other bomber above them right up here, right high up. So far, we're still in the fight because we've got the cannons coming from here and we've got the bot fly as well. But they're outmaneuvering me. Move to there, flick round. Now, watch the grape shots. Oh, yes, they don't like that. No. That thing's dead. Yes, the bot fly. When it gets close, two rifles, two grape shot cannon. Quite good. So I'm right above them now. They are still hitting me. I'm going to go on aimed fire for these ones. Because as you can see, ammo is already getting a little low. So I am getting hit. There are some rifle shots going up, but my shots are hopefully going to be a bit more Hurty. I'm going to stay at the front with the bot fire. The reason for that is then they have to decide whether to shoot at me or whether to shoot up. Looks like we've just absolutely blazed the front of that first structure, so we're going to move forward to the second. There's still some cannon shots coming from the left. I'm guessing that the overwhelm is still in play. Victory. There we go. Brutal takeover because it's... Oh, no. Channel takeover. However, we've lost the Overwhelmer and the Kingdom. One of the Kingdoms, anyway. So we're going to move the bot fly to there. And we now have some more areas. Excellent. That is most good. So, we've got that getting taken over, that almost taken over, and there's only really that left. However, we can't move off here because there's nothing to I've got here to defend it, so they can easily nick it. So I'm going to repair this structure here. This is one that we originally took over. That one we'll scrap it because we're just never going to be able to build that one. We'll also say build building dark cube and we'll build it. I think just building it right next door is fine. I think that's just how it goes. Further back, it just you get more shots on the way in. So that's going to get built. I'm going to do the same over to Stormness. Defenses. Oh no, because we gently took over, we've got all of those there. That's fine. And we've now got that taken over. So defenses, we've got our previous structures there. We'll repair this other one. We'll scrap that. Scrap that. And we'll scrap that. And we'll move this to there. And build building. A dark cube. Just some more cannons on it as well. So there we are. And now we're going to go over to... Actually, we need to build more. So, we've lost... We've lost all of our... major hitting power with the cannons. So what do? Well, we design something that's going to fix that. So, design ship. What weapons have we got? We have, now, dorsal turrets, and ventral turrets, and massive rockets. Yes, if I wanted to, I could make a vessel that looks a bit like this. And quite frankly, I'm trying to think of a reason why I shouldn't. Apart from the fact that it's stupid, because you can see the arc of fire is terrible on these things. It's either up or down. It's not it's not like anything else. Do I want to make something like that? Oh, you know what I'm really tempted to do? I'm tempted to retrofit the citadels with these. Fences, design building, dark cube. And the dorsal turret can go on the top like that. That would make it a lot stronger. A hell of a lot stronger, in fact. Because it means it can just fire straight up. It's going to make it a bit more expensive, but I don't particularly mind. Telescope can't go in. We'd have to get rid of something. That's a guard post, and that's a cockpit. And that's a guard post. We could get rid of that guard post, put the cockpit down there, and then put the telescope in there. Save design, as standard. I think. And leave that. I'll wait for these to be built and then I'll retrofit them. Actually, I'll retrofit the ones we've got. So defenses. That's alright. That's fine. We should really build the defenses in for that. So it's a lot more expensive, that's for sure. But I don't particularly mind. So refit it. Open the design of the dark cube, it replaces it, and you say refit, and there you go. And it doesn't take nowhere near as long. Excellent. So you can either go for a full-on assault and just keep assaulting, you know, more waves, more better. However, I am really of the opinion that we need to defend what we've taken, especially at this stage, because these can be easily nicked. So we want to refit that one. doesn't cost too much to refit them and doesn't take too long. I'm really tempted to go for the aerial jelly, but also there's dragons just appeared there. That's bad. I'm not gonna be able to do not gonna be able to deal with that for a while. Aerial hussars have now been finished. If we go for elite infantry, we get air dragoons and grappling hooks, but we don't have that there. We got triplanes and biplanes. I've also got efficient ammo storage, just plus 25% extra ammo storage, or minus 75% ammo storage flammability. We've got computers as well. That gives us a very big accuracy bonus. Where are suspendium cannons in this list, by the way? Suspendium cannons... there. Fair enough. Suspendium cannons are very, very, very long-range snipers. Very tiny arc of fire, but very accurate. And very, very hard-hitting. They'll just make a clean hole from one side to the other, like a railgun, essentially. Flamethrowers. Because then we eventually get the much wanted aerial torpedoes. And oh, okay, three events actually. Spelford has recovered from the war, so we're now getting full income off it. Oh my good grief, look at the size of that. I'm not gonna be able to deal with that. The Iron Escort and Dressil have joined an alliance. So these two have joined up to form an alliance here. So probably these two around here. So nothing major. And also, ground and ground. They're starting to build ground ships for some reason. Okay. Fair enough. I'm going to send a spy over there. Dark Cube's there. Dark Cube's been refit there. Dark Cube's been refitted there. We don't have a Dark Cube here. Do I want one? Don't really want one. Not with those three. Although it might be worth it. Build building Dark Cube. And then over here. That's fine. And I don't know why there's got... Oh, that's the flag. That's a flag. I just can't see the pole for it. Okay. So, we now have... Look, that's their defences there. It stretches from one side to the other. But it's actually not a lot. Oh, they've got rockets now as well, so they've refitted it all with rockets. And they've got a rocket tank as well. Yeah, so... Really now, it's a case of... seeing where we need to attack. I'm tempted to attack there. Deny them some more income. But I'm also tempted just to build a bigger vessel. Actually, speaking of defences. I should really place some defences in my home area, shouldn't I? And this is revolted. Oh. That's not good. The citizens of Noyuk revolt. So we've lost an area. I'm just going to build some more defences in my home city. We're going to have to deal with that then, so I guess we'll move down. I don't know what they've got there, but I'm hoping it's not going to be much. And whatever was there, actually, where are they? Where is that? Where is that? Is it just created a new nation? I think it might have done. So I'm going to have to deal with my own defences here, but that shouldn't be a massive problem. We have got the bomber to deal with that. And the bot flies, which is just going to charge straight in and take it out, hopefully quite quick. There's some rockets coming towards me because they've refitted that, and that one looks accurate. Ooh, just missed. So there's our grapeshot cannons in range now. But obviously they've got rockets. Actually, they've got flamethrowers as well. Sorry, had flamethrowers. That just disappeared. Looks like we're going to lose a bot fly. There's the first bot fly gone. Can't issue any commands on it. See, the rocket's going straight up. That's the thing with rockets. Rockets are highly inaccurate, but very... They cause a lot of splash damage, and they've got a great arc of fire. There we go. That's a fight one. Not without casualties, though. Not without casualties. So we've taken that over. We'll go to defences. We'll repair that. Move it to there. Can't build anything, but we are going to move these back to our main city. And we've got cultists appeared now. We've got all sorts of problems there. So we'll put these back here. We will repair them. What it does is it knows what the original design was, and then it puts it back to that. So, interesting and eventful. We will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 towns, and ideally we need another city, and it's going to be Dean, I think. They've got a lot of defences, a lot of rockets. We need a lot of bombers and some sort of, quite frankly, some sort of large vessel with a lot of guns on the front to deal with that. And that's what we'll do, hopefully, next episode. Unless we get attacked in the meantime, because we only know what's going to happen there. We have no idea, actually. Only one generic unit of deity knows. As always, hope you have enjoyed the video. Comments in the comments. Thanks very much for watching. Take care and generic partings.